Hello and welcome back to No Bullshit. Today we return to talking about the corrupt mainstream media, specifically NBC, who has a terrible actor and anchor who has done a very awful thing. They've misquoted and deceptively edited a video about A.G. Barr, who was talking about Flynn, who recently had a big scandal of his own. There's a lot of details and moving parts here, but basically NBC has been caught lying once again. Chuck Todd is a terrible anchor and host there who does really awful work, frankly. He's a bad interviewer, bad faith actor, and this news story exposes that. He's kind of deceptively edited this video, which featured A.G. Barr. This is, of course, Attorney General Barr. He's the top cop in the land, Trump's number one man in charge of the policing and stuff like that. He's like the head lawyer, and he's been caught kind of being misedited, being misrepresented by this terrible anchor named Chuck Todd. And what A.G. Barr was talking about was the whole Flynn drama. Flynn was this former national security advisor for Trump who had to be fired during this whole controversy a few years back. And frankly, what happened was he got screwed over and got caught, and the FBI turned on him with some frame job that got exposed recently and made things look really bad for the left. The left is in damage control mode. This is all connected to other things like Obamagate, which we talked about before. We've talked about this controversy in a number of different ways, and this is just one facet of it, but it's very interesting, very telling. So let's jump right into the story. It says, NBC admits Chuck Todd's Meet the Press deceptively edited Barr remarks on Flynn. So they even admitted this. This is a full admission of guilt. They deceptively edited a video of the guy, probably trying to make him say something different or something out of context. We'll get more details as we read on. NBC News' Chuck Todd aired a deceptively edited clip of Attorney General Bill Barr discussing the Michael Flynn case during his Meet the Press broadcast on Sunday, prompting the network to concede the mistake hours later. But there is still no word on whether Todd will apologize on air. Some are even asking for him to resign, which is definitely possible. I doubt if it will really happen because liberals always get away with this stuff, but this is a really bad mess up. This is the kind of stuff that people don't come back from, especially in reporting. I mean, we're in a different world right now where reporters can lie and make shit up all the time, but back in the day, just 5 or 10 years ago even, people used to get fired for this all the time because there was an expectation. Reporters need to stick with the facts. If they get something wrong, they get reprimanded. I mean, it's not like you can make no mistakes ever, but this is essentially like a leftist reporter making up a story. It's like the Shattered Glass movie where the guy just constantly made things up and then eventually got caught, but they didn't want to bring down the newspaper. That's a whole other story, but I think you get the point. Asked by CBS News' Catherine Herridge how history would judge the DOJ's decision to move to dismiss the Flynn case, Barr initially responded laughing, "Well, history is written by the winner, so it largely depends on who's writing the history." Kind of a way to say that. After the brief clip aired, Todd remarked that he was struck by the cynicism of the answer. It's a correct answer, but he's the attorney general. He didn't make the case that he was upholding the rule of law. He was almost admitting that, yeah, this was a political job. In the full clip, though, which the NBC show did not air, Barr immediately went on to state explicitly that, in fact, he felt that the Flynn decision upheld the rule of law. "I think a fair history would say it was a good decision because it upheld the rule of law," Barr said. "It upheld the standards of the Department of Justice and undid what was an injustice." The Daily Caller's Greg Price had called out the edit earlier Sunday. So here's the edit being called out, and maybe we'll show a clip of that in a second. But the point here is, yeah, that thing sounded bad. We saw the quote, we saw the words, and it sounded kind of bad for A.G. Barr to say history is written by the winners. It's kind of like saying, oh, we're going to get away with it because we won. You know, it sounds a little shady, but as the other people have started to say, Chuck Todd pulled that quote out of context, and he's telling them, you know, Barr said things afterwards that kind of confirmed that he thought the right thing happened, even though this edit implied he didn't. And then Greg Price says, "Today on Meet the Press, Chuck Todd wildly took out of context an answer A.G. Barr gave about his decision to drop the case into General Michael Flynn. I cut Todd's segment along with Barr's full answer together. Look how blatantly dishonest this is." Okay, so we're going to check that out next. All right, I got the clip queued up. It has 1.7 million views. This is a rebuttal showing how Chuck Todd lied about A.G. Barr. Let's check it out.
You brought up Bill Barr. Peggy Noonan, I want you to listen to this Bill Barr answer to a question about what will history say about this. Wait till you hear this answer. Take a listen.
"When history looks back on this decision, how do you think it will be written?"
"Well, history's written by the winner, so it largely depends on who's writing the history.
I was struck, Peggy, by the cynicism of the answer.
Well, I was struck by the way you cut him off so badly. I mean, he was already into another sentence. It wasn't like an easy cut there. There wasn't even a pause. He was about to say something else, about to clear something up. And you could tell he's kind of has a joking manner to him here. He says, history is written by the winners. That's just a cheeky kind of quote. That's also true, but it is cynical, but it is kind of something he followed up on very easily. Chuck Todd thinks he has a cute little clip here, him and his little half hair over there. And he does it. He had this planned up before and he thinks it's good, but now he's being exposed as pulling it out of context pretty badly, as we'll soon see here.
It's a correct answer, but he's the attorney general. He didn't make the case that he was upholding the rule of law. He was almost admitting that, yeah, this is a political job.
Yeah, and that's the quote we went over before. We're about to get to the official quote. But I don't see it, man. I don't see this Chuck Todd guy just looks like a typical, you know, very beta leftist trying to attack someone by taking words out, and just very, very cringe, very low key, like very just off color and not interesting.
When history looks back on this decision, how do you think it will be written?
Well, history is written by the winner, so it largely depends on who's writing the history. But I think a fair history would say it was a good decision because it upheld the rule of law. It upheld the standards of the Department of Justice, and it undid what was an injustice.
Okay, that's a much more explained answer. He makes sense. He just says the quote at the beginning as a kind of introduction to what his real response is, where he says, justice was upheld, Flynn was mistreated, and now the facts have come out. Flynn was kind of framed up by the Justice Department, by FBI, and they were trying to use him to work against Trump. That was the whole plan, and that's why he had to be fired, because he was caught kind of doing bad things within Trump's administration. They knew he was kind of this puppet for the other side, but he didn't have a choice at the same side. So that's a whole other thing. AG Barr is obviously making the right call. And Chuck Todd is obviously a total hack. I mean, he has this clip prepared. He set it up like he was really zinging the guy, when really he was misrepresenting the guy purposely, trying to make him look bad, trying to make a Trump person that he doesn't like look terrible, and it's coming off making him look far worse. Back to the article, we're going to get to Trump's response to this shortly, but first, it says this. In response, the Meet the Press Twitter account posted, "You're correct. Earlier today, we inadvertently and inaccurately cut short a clip of interview of AG Barr before offering commentary and analysis. The remaining clip included important remarks from the Attorney General that we missed, and we regret the error. Inadvertently strikes again," tweeted independent journalist Mike Cernovich. He's kind of calling them out for saying inadvertently, when obviously this was done purposely. This was intentional. They cut the clip. They took the line that they wanted and totally distorted it, and they're doing it to use as a weapon against us, when really they're getting exposed and they're exposing themselves as hacks who don't really care about the truth. They don't really care about reporting and telling people facts and information. They care far more about winning and getting their political things chosen and winning their democratic elections and stuff like that. They care about cheating and making money over actually getting the facts out there. And that's why it's getting so disappointing. And it's a terrible apology here too, where they're trying to not take blame for it. They're trying to act like it was an accident. I don't know how you accidentally cut off the clip in the part of a sentence, like in the middle of a sentence. We could clearly see he was starting to speak more on the first clip from NBC News, but they muted it. They took the sound down, which I could tell very easily being an editor myself. And that's just not an inadvertent thing. Inadvertent means like almost accidental, like you didn't intend to do this. But this was an intentional thing that they're trying to cover up and say it was an accident. So they're not really apologizing. Next, Donald Trump chimes in. He says, "Sleepy Eyes Chuck Todd should be fired by Comcast for this fraud. He knew exactly what he was doing. Public airwaves equals fake news at the FCC." And Ajit Pai, who's the head of the FCC, Molly says, "A tweet in no way covers the error." So that's him responding to Molly, talking about the story. Donald Trump's calling for the firing, talking about Comcast, which is Comcast, who owns NBC, that network. And this is on the public airways. This is on the biggest, one of the biggest networks, like one of the big five. This is like the free channels here in America: ABC, NBC, CBS, Fox. There's like four or five free network channels that you could get over the air, and they're still the biggest ones, and they're spreading this fake news in their reporting. I mean, this is just straight up misleading, misrepresenting. This is like the stuff they'll say we're conspiracy theorists for claiming this, but we have proof of it happening right here. I mean, where's the conspiracy? Where is the lie? We're talking about misrepresenting. We're talking about reporters who are supposed to be the top of their game on a top network, and they're just pulling this kind of shenanigans. It's very unreal. It's very surreal. It's very upsetting, and I can see why the president would say someone should probably be fired for this. But the show did not say it would apologize on air. NBC News did not respond to Fox News' request for information about an on-air apology either. A tweet in no way covers the error, wrote the Federalist Molly Hemingway. A lot of people are rightly angry at Chuck Todd for willfully lying about AG Barr's comments on rule of law, but Joe NBC also did it days ago. These intentional lies in service of false narratives have gone on for years, infuriating. That was a reference in part to NBC's Joe Scarborough sharing a debunked, deceptively edited clip of VP Mike Pence handing off boxes of PPE. Okay, that's great. I'm glad they brought up that story because we covered that previously too. We talked about VP Mike Pence and he had a little photo op carrying some boxes to a hospital. Jimmy Kimmel was one of the more famous people to attack him for that, claiming he had carried empty boxes in like a photo stunt situation. Now, we all admit that we knew it was a photo op. We knew it was there to get press for his task force and for the Trump administration, but there's nothing wrong with that inherently. People need to do press conferences and press events all the time. The fact that the problem here was they lied about him and said it was fake boxes based on a cherry-picked quote that was taken out of context, very similar to what happened to AG Barr here. So this is another situation where it's important for us to keep calling this out. The left is deceptively editing clips. They're taking quotes out of context. They're lying about people. They're making shit up just to fulfill their Democratic policies. They don't care about the truth. They're not reporters. These are propaganda artists. Other bloggers like Jim Treacher and Tim Pool, a journalist, are among influential commentators explicitly seeking an on-air apology. Yeah, well, I think that's the least he could do. I mean, I think NBC kind of punishing Chuck Todd or his company or his, you know, his producers or something would be more likely or more interesting, but I doubt any of that's going to happen. That's not the point. The greater point is we're exposing this. We're showing that these people are liars and fakes and fake news peddlers, left-wing propagandists. They don't care about the truth. They're not reporters. They're not real fact checkers. They're fake checkers. They're fake news peddlers who will deceptively edit clips about Republicans, about people in Trump's administration with ease. They don't care. They'll present lies. And we're here to combat them and tell you guys what is really going on. That about wraps things up in today's video. Thanks for watching. Make sure you comment your thoughts and everything below. Really look forward to seeing what you guys have to say. Also, you can leave some video ideas below this video too. If you have any thoughts or any stories you want me to cover, comment them below. I'll be reading. Also, leave a like if you enjoyed this video, subscribe if you're new, hit the bell for notifications, and also you can check out extra videos on our second channel called No BS News. Thanks for your time today, guys. Make sure you all have a good day.